Hey, it's Clay at claytrader.com. This will be my top 10 stocks as we head into Friday, August 16th. This will be a technical analysis breakdown, so if you are someone that uses charts within your trading, or maybe you're just interested in learning more about charts and how they can be used as a tool to help make good decisions as a trader, this will be a video for you. And also, if you trade Bitcoin, I'll do a bonus analysis at the end. First off, a couple clarifications. Number one, the candlestick that you see right there will be moving around and changing. That is because the market's still open for a small amount of time. But I like to do these videos when the market is still open because sometimes we can capture some really interesting late day price movement. Second, I'll be using the 30 minute time frame, meaning each one of these candlesticks here represents 30 minutes worth of time. So stock number one, ticker symbol TPST, big mover today, lots of volume, and now you've got a pullback on it, which creates a very interesting situation. So to reiterate, you can see right there, huge move up. And then on the pullback, this is where things get interesting because you can see that not once, but three times. So we had one time there and then two times right there. The price came down there and has really respected that pink line, which on my chart denotes the very well known, the very famous 200 period moving average. So from a support standpoint, if you're someone that's like to play bounce, right there around the $1.50 mark is going to be a very interesting level. Is it guaranteed to continue to bounce from there? No such thing as a guarantee. My point here is that it's plausible to think that if the price, you know, goes back down there, it could very well get another bounce, and that, you know, that's going to be a very important level from a support standpoint. Now, if you want to play your deeper pullback, if the price falls below that pink line, next key level you'd want to watch very closely is that purple line there, the 50 period moving average, which is valued at $1.30. In the event the price tries to bounce back upwards, key area from the resistance standpoint at that point, going to be right there around the $1.71 mark. But all in all, if you like to play movements that get those big solid upwards momentums, then and then you get those pullbacks that are now sitting around some very well-defined areas of support, that definitely fits the bill on all those fronts. Next one, SQQQ. This one's getting beat down quite a bit, but now we're starting to get an interesting situation here where, yeah, it's still dropping, but you can see the rate at which it's dropping is not nearly as, you know, catastrophic as what it's been before. I mean, look at this section right here. I mean, just straight down here. But here, not quite. And then along with that, you can see the price is now starting to go sideways. Now, let me be very clear, and I wish I could say trading was this easy. Just because the price is not going down as quickly and it's now started to go sideways a bit does not mean that for sure guaranteed this is the bottom, that for sure guaranteed this thing is getting ready to skyrocket back upwards. My point, again, goes back to plausibility. Is it at least reasonable? Is it plausible to think that this thing is maybe trying to bottom out? Absolutely. So on that note, let me change that to green to represent support. Key area of support moving forward, going to be right down there around the $8.20 mark. And you want to see the price stay up above that area. Although as I speak, you can see it's actually getting maybe even a little closer to there. But even if the price were to fall down below there, it doesn't take away from the fact that this downwards pressure does seem to be alleviating. So we'll see if this thing does continue to bottom out and then maybe get a bounce in the upward direction. And even if it is just a dead cat bounce, from a trading standpoint, that's all we need. We just need a little bit of movement, and then we can make that work for us. In regards to levels of resistance, key level to keep an eye on, give me that resistance area right there, so keep a close eye on that. If the price can push up through there, that would be a leading indicator that maybe the bulls are starting to make an appearance. So we'll see what happens with it on Friday. Next one, CING, and pretty kind of chart all over the place. I mean, ultimately, it is bullish, but you had the big move up, then you had this pullback, then you had this big move up, and now you have a pullback right here. So that, I suppose, leads right to the question, is this going to happen here? Will the pattern repeat itself? Certainly a plausible question to throw out there. So let's map out a couple of the key areas from a support standpoint and what I would call the ideal level of support. When you say, Clay, what would make the chart look the absolute strongest going forward? And that would be if the price can stay above this trend line right there. Now, if the price falls below it, not the end of the world because not that far away, you then have the pink line down here, the 200 period moving average currently valued at, we'll call it 352. But yes, in terms of making it look the healthiest from a bullish standpoint, certainly staying above that trend line would accomplish that. And then in regards to levels of resistance, main battleground in my mind seems to be right up there around the 607 mark. So keep a close eye on that. And we'll see if this little miniature wedge continues to form. So you can see it's kind of chopping around. So does it chop around and then finally get the break? Definitely worth keeping an eye on if you like this price range on Friday. Next one, VSME, had a very, very nice afternoon in terms of just consolidating, consolidating, consolidating. And then you can see right here, the floodgates started to open up. And now as I speak, this 30-minute candle right here, the price continues to drop. So yeah, things are looking pretty rough, but there is still a very interesting situation down here around this level right here at the 79-cent mark. Now, this is interesting for a couple different reasons. First off, it would be this former area of resistance. It would be a gap close location. Those areas tend to act as support. And then also, down around that area, you have the purple line. They don't match up exactly, but hopefully we can agree they're certainly both close to one another. And that's another area where it would be reasonable to think that there could be support. I know I've said this, and I'll probably say it a dozen more times. There are no guarantees, but it is certainly plausible to think that if the price were to come down here, it could indeed find some support at those couple levels before starting to turn itself back around. So right around that 79-80 cent mark, definitely is an area where if you like to play these pullbacks, that can make a lot of sense. Of course, there is some downwards pressure for sure that's showing up. So if you're not going to be, you know, disciplined, if you're not going to honor risk and stop loss and all that, I mean, you shouldn't even be trading, but you certainly shouldn't be trading situations like this. But yeah, nasty pullback right here. So if you like these situations where you can try to find those bounces within the world of penny stocks, then keep an eye on it. Next one here, NVDA. And this will mean a little bit more to those of you that watched the video from yesterday, but if you did, hopefully you remember me talking about that resistance line right there, and you can see got the breakout from there, and then it has since made a very, very impressive move in the upwards direction. So good to see that and how powerful it ended up behaving when it did break up through there. Now, what about new levels? Well, let's first just get rid of these as they've served their purpose for now. So in terms of levels of support, just to simplify this, no pun intended, but just continue to watch a purple line there, 50 period moving average. As that line moves itself higher and higher, it's basically a trend line that's drawn itself for you. So as long as the price remains above the trend line, then the overall, the trend is by definition still in the upwards direction, which is what you want to see. And then in terms of areas of resistance, to just offer up a little bit more context, you can see that it's been quite a while. There we go. Since the price has been up this high, I know things are harder to see, but that's a good problem to have. Because, like I said, just suggests that it's been a long time since the price hasn't been up around there. But 124.50 is going to be the next key overarching area of resistance. You can see it presented some problems back there from back in the month of July. And then you can see right here, still got a little wiggle room to go before it gets up to that area. But if it does, again, 124.50 is going to be that main battleground. But all in all, things are looking great. Price is putting these higher lows. And that's the name of the game as far as building those uptrends. Real quick, want to take a break and personally invite you to get signed up for this live online webinar that I'm offering. So if you've been enjoying what you've seen and you want to learn more about this tool, how it can and should be used to build consistency and manage risk, then definitely get signed up. If you're watching on YouTube, there's a link down in the description box you can use. Or if you're watching at my site, there's an area right there on the webpage you can use to sign up. Now, note, it is a genuine live event. So maybe a couple situations, maybe you already have something on your schedule this evening, or maybe you're watching this Friday and you totally missed it. If that is okay, go ahead, send me an email, and I will gladly send you a link to the replay so that you can watch it when it fits into your schedule. But if you can make it live, then definitely get signed up, and I'll see you here in just a few hours. Next one here, ticker symbol ASTS, and I don't know what to say about this one other than absolute monster today. Gap up, and then green candle after green candle, finally got a red candle right here. But, you know, watch this in many ways is just finding interesting situations, and that's it. And in my mind, this is a unique and interesting situation. Like I said, not very often do you see stocks with this amount of volume essentially go straight up. So those two things in and of itself make it watch worth worthy. Now, I want to give you a little bit more data than that, so we'll talk about some resistances in sports. But finally, this thing, as far as resistances, started to act human right up there around 33.50. So no fancy rationale behind that other than simply asking the question, where did the party finally stop today? And that was up at 33.50. So keep an eye on that as that main area of resistance. And then as far as areas of support are concerned, if this thing's going to pull back more, initial key level to watch right there around $29.50. But that would be the ideal level that I've talked about before, meaning that would be the area that would make the chart look the absolute strongest moving forward. Looking at things from the bigger picture, though, just watch that purple line there, 50 period moving average. As it moves itself higher and higher, as long as the price stays above that line, then ultimately the bulls are still in full health and full control. But yeah, just again, setting all that aside, and just if you're sitting there saying, I'm a day trader, I love volume, I love volatility, I love stocks that are moving, yeah, it certainly fits the bill in those two categories for sure. Next one here, TSLA Tesla, and good solid pattern here has formed. So let's get this pattern drawn into play. So we have our resistance part of the pattern. We have the support part. Let me change that to green. And then just to make it easier to see, let's keep it one color. So we have our resistance. We have our support. We have the huge move up right here. And this would be a bull pennant, bull flag, however you want to look at that. Now, let me be very clear. Just because something's a bullish pattern doesn't mean for sure guaranteed it's going upwards. But You know, I don't think it would shock anybody if somebody said, hey, Tesla had a green Friday. It would be like, well, yeah, it had a bull pennant on Thursday, so not totally shocking. So if you like these sorts of patterns, whether you trade the stock straight up or if you like trade options, because Tesla obviously is a very well-known stock, very liquid, has very liquid options, certainly keep an eye on this bull pennant. Next one here, AMZN, and this is the one where I'm going to call for more of a pullback. Now, real quick before you get too angry, pullback is not the same as reversal. I just think this thing is going to have some profit taking showing up, and that is based off of the pattern here that I'm going to draw into play here. And that is what is known as a rising wedge, which is a bearish pattern. Now, as I just said, just because something's bullish doesn't mean the price for sure going to go up. Just because something's bearish does not mean the price for sure going to go down. But I don't think anybody would be shocked to say that, oh yeah, Amazon had a pullback on Friday. Once more, pullback not the same as a reversal. But this rising wedge here does suggest that this thing needs to pull back a bit more. And really, as long as the pullbacks don't violate down through that pink line right there, then I would say there's absolutely zero to worry about. Even if the price were to drop below the pink line, still not the end of the world, because you do have the purple line right there, the 50 period moving average. But like I said, for sure, in my opinion, as long as price is at least above that pink line, then truly nothing to worry about. So Amazon's got the rising wedge. Is it going to lead to a pullback? We'll see what happens on Friday. Next one, PLTR, and the overall upward move continues. Yeah, it slowed down here a little bit, but overall it is hanging in there. So let's map out a couple key levels of resistance. So first battleground to watch closely, going to be right up here at $31.50. No fancy reasoning other than that is just where the price struggled this morning, essentially three times in a row up there. Price tried to get through that level and can never quite do it. So keep an eye on that. That does not mean that 3150 can never be broken. I'm just saying that according to the history of the chart, that's telling us apparently the price really is going to need to bring it to A game if it's going to be able to fight up through that level right there. And then in terms of areas of support, we're going to go ahead and just make this very straightforward. Just continue to watch out purple line there, 50 period moving average. As I zoom out, you'll see that the purple line here has done a very, very good job of providing the support ever since the price got above it right there. You can see that, I suppose, got kind of close right there. And it's just been doing a fantastic job of maintaining above it. So as long as the price is above that purple line, the bulls are truly in full control. Even if the price drops below it, not the end of the world, because you still do have that pink line down there. But yeah, preferably speaking, staying above that purple line, as it's been doing, indicates the bulls are in full health. Next one, ticker symbol TQQQ, and overall, very nice day on this one. Had the wedge going into today, has broken up through there, so I'm just going to get rid of that level, make the first update, and that's just basic rule. When levels of resistance are broken and closed above, you want to see them act as support. So 64 is an area of support. I'm going to go ahead and adjust this area up, though, now. And whatever levels of support need to be adjusted in the upward direction, that's definitely always a good thing. And that what, you know, needs to happen here. So preferably speaking, 65.95, if the price can stay above there, that would make the chart look the best. But if the price does not hold above it, then yeah, you guessed it. That purple line there, as it moves itself higher and higher, as long as the price stays above there, bulls are in full health. In terms of areas of resistance, no need to overcomplicate this. This thing has just been grinding and grinding. And where did the party finally stop today? That makes it easy. Right up there at 68.68. So that'll be the main battleground. But if you're somebody that likes to play, you know, uptrends, then this thing ever since the crazy day over a week ago with the higher lows, I mean, it just keeps grinding higher and higher. So if you envision those as stair steps right there, assuming you're bullish, that is the name of the game. I'll get to Bitcoin here in just a second, but for you stock traders, again, if you like what you saw here, then definitely get signed up for the free live class. It'll be this evening, Thursday, August 15th at 7 p.m. Eastern time, and I hope to see you there. But if you can't make it live for whatever reason, go ahead and send me an email to clay@claytrader.com, and I'd be happy to send you a link to the replay. And definitely bring your questions, because it is genuinely live, and I say that because there will be a live Q&A session. So if you bring your questions, I'd be happy to answer them for you. All right, now let's talk some Bitcoin. One quick clarification here. I am now using the 4-hour time frame. So each one of these candlesticks here represents 4 hours as opposed to 30 minutes. And now I like to do the 4-hour time frame because Bitcoin is open 24/7. So that'll allow this analysis and video to remain relevant for as long as possible. But yeah, to state the obvious, past 4 hours have not been very good at all. Big move to the downside. And now we have some key questions here. So I'm going to just assume you're watching this video 15, 20 hours after I upload it. So question number one you need to ask yourself is, where is the price currently at relative to 57,700? Right now, yes, it is slightly below it. but it's not like it's super far below it. So in any way, shape, or form, if you're saying, well, actually, Clay, it's 15 hours after you uploaded it, I'm watching it, the price is up above 57,700, that is a good thing. Because that implies that this downward move has not only stopped, but actually recovered back upwards. So if it's sitting right around there, still a good thing. Now, how good of a thing? That is where common sense comes into play. If you're saying, well, actually, Clay, the price is all the way up here, well, obviously that would be a very bullish situation because that would be that much bigger of a move backwards. But bare minimum, any answering above 57,700 implies there's some bullishness here because it has stopped. Now, if you're saying, well, actually, Clay, the price is still down below 57,700. Next key question is, okay, well, where's the price at relative to 54,500? If you are answering the question that the price is down below there, that means that this was just the start and the bears have picked up that much more strength and they're starting to take back over control. If you're answering the question that the price is just somewhere right around here, well, then that could be a little bit more bleeding, of course, but I would still just call that consolidation. But in my mind, that is a key level. If you're answering any questions with the price being down below there, that is not good at all from the bullish side of things. Now, if you're bearish, if you're short, well, then you would love that. But just from a bullish angle, that wouldn't be good. So walk yourself through those questions, keep your eye on these levels, and that'll keep this analysis relevant for the next 24 hours. As I invited the stock traders, I'm inviting you as a Bitcoin and crypto trader to definitely go get signed up for this free class, because what you're learning about can and certainly should be used within the world of crypto and Bitcoin. So like I said, it'll be this evening, Thursday, August 15th at 7 p.m. Eastern time. Go get signed up. If you can't make it live, go ahead, send me an email, clay@claytrader.com. As far as these top 10 videos are concerned, if you enjoy these, please do a couple things for me. Hit that like button, leave a comment below, say hello, tell me what your watch list is for tomorrow. If you're of a position that you'd like for me to do an analysis on, put that in the comment section and I'll do my best to get to that in a future top 10 video. So thanks for watching. Go get signed up for that free class. And if you can't make it live, send me an email, but hopefully I will see you here in just a few hours.